next question says a 60 kg body is pushed with just enough force to start it moving across a floor, and the same force continues to act afterwards. The coefficient of static and sliding friction are 0.5 and 0.4 respectively. The acceleration of the body is. Now we can say initially the weight is definitely mg. There is a normal reaction, and the force applied is to just overcome the static friction force. So F is equal to Fs, which is mu s n, and that is mu s mg. Now mu s given is 0.5, m given as 60, g we can take it as 9.8. That makes this as 30 into 9.8. Now for a time being we can assume this is the force applied. So if the body starts moving, the static friction gets converted to kinetic or sliding friction. So now the force applied is still the same, but the friction which opposes the force is going to be Fk. Since Fk is going to be less than the Fs, there will be motion, which is Ma. So here we can say Ma is equal to F minus Fk. Now M is 60. F we got 30 into 9.8. Minus Fk is going to be mu k mg, where mu k is 0.4, m is 60, g is still 9.8. Now if you understand this, I can cancel this 30, make this 2, make this 2. So this becomes 2a is equal to 9.8 taken common, bracket will have 1 minus 0.8. which makes it 0.2. So if you cancel this 2 with this, you'll get it as 0.1. So 9.8 into 0.1 will give the acceleration as 0.98 meter per second square, which can be rounded off to 1. So acceleration is 1 meter per second square as the final answer.